Hey everyone, Dr. Andy Galpin here. We're back with another episode of 5-Minute Physiology where I take important topics from things like nutrition, exercise, strength and conditioning, and physiology and break them down and give you the nitty-gritty in 5 minutes or less. Today's topic, lactate metabolism. Lactate's one of my favorite molecules of all time because you can't read a magazine, go to the gym, or even watch a football game without hearing someone talk about lactic acid buildup and or clearing the lactate out the day after a hard workout, well, it's why you're still sore, or some nonsense like that. And it makes me laugh, it actually makes me feel bad for poor little lactate because everyone hates it. All right, it's the bane of your existence, it's the reason why you failed. So I wanted to make this short video to help you understand a little bit more about lactate so you understand what it actually is and you can stop blaming it for all your crappy problems, your athletic problems anyways. Now I'm just going to give you a quick shot of it in this video. If this excites you or you want to hear more about it, check out the 25-minute or even 55-minute physiology videos I made on lactate. But to understand what's basically happening here, you have to realize that lactate is a byproduct of anaerobic metabolism. So it's only being generated, in other words, when you break down glucose for fuel. Okay, now glucose is basically the same word as sugar or carbohydrate in this sense, right? And for this particular talk, we're talking about human skeletal muscle and exercise. But when we do that, what we're saying here is, look, carbohydrate is the word itself, carbon and hydrate. And you can see from the picture here, what I'm talking about is glucose specifically is a 6-carbon chain. So it's 6 carbons and 6 waters, carbohydrate. Now when I break down glucose for energy, that process is called glycolysis. Okay, it splits the glucose into 2 separate 3-carbon molecules called pyruvate. Now I make a little bit of energy here, but I had to invest some into it to get there. So in other words, I spent $5, I made $10, so I net gained $5. Now what you're gaining in this particular case is some energy that you use to form a molecule called ATP. ATP is the energy currency for all of biology. Human, not human, it doesn't really matter. In fact, it's the same currency that you use in your red blood cells to generate energy, your brain, your skeletal muscle, whatever. So you can see we make a little bit of ATP right over here in the corner. Okay? Now, our body realizes though that we spent we gained 10, we netted $5. I can't live off of $5. So we're not really trying to make ATP here. We're trying to make pyruvate so that we can use that to make a bunch more ATP later. If we have oxygen available, we can ship the pyruvate to the mitochondria. That can be converted into another little molecule that can go through a thing called the TCA or citric acid cycle. That'll go on to the electron transport chain, and that'll generate a bunch of ATP. In fact, it's probably 10 or 20-fold the ATP created here than we went through glycolysis in the very beginning. So this is the real end game. Unfortunately, this process doesn't work if I don't have oxygen. Because oxygen is a requirement to go into the mitochondria, and that's a requirement, of course, of aerobic or oxidative metabolism. So what your body says is, okay, look, what I'll do is start shifting pyruvate over to something else. Now, what we have to understand here is what hydrogen is. Hydrogen are often referred to as a proton, which is H+. That's acid. So pH, that's what it stands for, potential hydrogen. In other words, if you have a lot of free-floating acid or free-floating hydrogen, you are acidic. Okay, so you start taking your pyruvate and you start saying, here we go, I know I've generated a bunch of acid. Picture yourself on that awful aerodyne bike, right? That's in our house, we have a saying that there's no winning with the aerodyne, only losing, right? It's the worst exercise thing ever. It's awesome, right? Just tremendous. Picture yourself, you're on that aerodyne, you're doing something like 20 seconds as hard as you can, 20 seconds off, and you do 10 rounds of that or something like we did the other day, and you generate a bunch of acid. What you can do is start attaching that acid to the pyruvate. Now, because it's not free floating around, it doesn't cause an acidic environment. When we take a pyruvate and attach an H+ to it, or hydrogen proton, we call that new molecule lactate. So that's all lactate really is. It's a pyruvate that's holding on to hydrogen for you. So not only is lactate not causing all of your problems, don't blame it for all your weak ass endurance. It's actually being a buffer. In other words, it's stopping you from becoming acidic because it is holding on to a hydrogen proton. I can also then, because it is simply, it is just pyruvate with a hydrogen, if I can bring some O2 into the arena, I can combine a couple of hydrogens with that oxygen I just brought in and make H2O. And so I can peel that hydrogen back off of the lactate, combine it with O2, make water, and then once I've left the hydrogen, I'm now back in my pyruvate state, which is an amazing form of sugar. It can also be used as a hormone or a signaling molecule to tell the rest of your body and other tissues throughout your system what's going on. So we can ship lactate to other exercising muscles. So say I'm on that aerodyne and I'm burning really hard in my quads. I can ship lactate to, say, my shoulders or something like that. They can strip the hydrogen by combining it with oxygen and make them give themselves some free sugar. We do the same thing at the heart and the same thing actually with the liver in a little process called the Cori cycle, where we actually go through gluconeogenesis and we take two lactates, combine them together, and make a brand new glucose molecule. What some of the recent research is actually showing is that your brain will do the same thing. So your brain, that we know primarily runs off of glucose metabolism, and since lactate is basically a broken down glucose, if we have oxygen in our brain, we can combine it, make water, make pyruvate, and power your brain. This is probably why we know that things like cognitive function, memory are improved in kids or people taking final exams, or you perform better at your job when you work out really hard. You are directly creating lactate, which directly fuels your brain. Got any questions about this? Let me know on social media at Dr. Andy Galpin. If you're not on my website, you can go to my website to check out more of these types of videos, andygalpin.com.